Hello everybody, I am Kishaloy Das. I am from Kolkata. I secured GATE All India Rank 37 this year from computer science background. I also got selected for ISRO scientist post. So I am very happy and delighted that finally my dreams come true and all those hard works for last 2 years finally paid off. So it's a very happy moment for me and my family and my friends. So I decided that in this video I'll share my experience regarding these two examinations, like ISRO and GATE, because these two are my prime target to achieve. So I'll share my experience to all the future aspirants. So I'll start with GATE because that is the main preparation that you all have to take, and then we'll come to the ISRO part because that is a sub part of this GATE preparation, subset of GATE's preparation. So let's start with my experience with GATE. Now first phase is concept building. It's very crucial actually for GATE preparation. As you all know that GATE is an examination that is conducted by IITs, the best technical institute in our country, and they hardly repeat any question in each year GATE. What they repeat is the concept. So concept building is very important. You have to have a sound knowledge on each and every topic of your subjects, and that's very crucial actually. So I'll suggest you to read standard books and some standard lectures from different renowned universities to build your concept actually. There is a misconception. Many people I have seen that they used to follow study material. Don't follow study material for theory study, because those are not actually much reliable. It's better to follow different standard books and video lectures by different professors. Of like for IIT we have NPTEL, and even in YouTube you will find many other universities and their courses. So follow them and make sure that you have a sound knowledge on those subjects. Let me share the books that I have actually I have followed for my preparation. For algorithm I follow Coleman book. For data structure I have followed Sahani book, and for both algorithm data structure I followed Professor Naveen Garg's lecture from IIT Delhi. Discrete math I have followed Rosen. Engineering math you can follow any book of your plus two. For TOC you can follow Peter Lynch, or there is a lecture in NPTEL by Professor Biswas from IIT Kanpur. You can follow that. That's really good actually. Compiler Ullman is the best book, and there is a lecture by Professor Agarwal from IIT Kanpur. You can refer that. Networking for the beginner, Farhausen is a good book to follow. But if you really have to really have a depth knowledge in networking, you should follow Tannenbaum. COA follow Hamacher or Mano. Operating system Galvin is the most is a standard book. For digital I suggest you to follow Salaria or Mano. And finally for database management system you can follow Navathi or Gore. So these are the books that you need to first read and make sure that you have a sound knowledge on each and every subject, because unless and until you have a clear knowledge just by solving papers, you will not make it to top 100 or anything top 50. So make sure that you are first reading these books or these courses, and make sure that you have a good knowledge on each and every subject. Now once you have done with your concept building part and you have already studied all those books and lectures, next step will be solving previous year papers, because those are the papers that has been set by IITs previously, and if you solve them you will get a idea that how the actual questions are formed and from which area actually they used to focus for building the questions. So it's very important that you have to solve the previous year's paper first. Now there are different sources from where you can get those papers, and second thing I want to say that how you will solve those papers. I will suggest you to, you know, if you first read the questions and try by yourself and spend a quality of time behind each and every questions. Think about it, read the questions well, because one of my teachers told me that GATE questions are a mystery to solve. Each and every word has a meaning, each and every sentence have a meaning. So if you just hurry to the answer and see the answer, those mystery will not be there, it will be meaningless. So better you try by yourself, you read the questions, think about it, spend some amount of time, okay, read a theory, you know, on the basis of that questions, and try to solve by yourself, and then you go to Gate Overflow, see the answer, see the comments, all. But first you try by yourself, that's what I want to say, and it's actually help you to know actually. So this is very crucial. After concept building, you have to solve the previous year paper. Now the next phase is mock tests. After concept building and previous year question solve, you have to appear for mock test, because what I have seen is like for GATE success, and 70% role is played by your preparation, how well you are preparing, but 30% is, you know, handling the pressure in the exam hall. I have seen many cases where people had a good preparation, but in exam hall they can't handle the pressure, they can't make their mind cool, and they, you know, they made some silly mistake, and they end up with an unexpected rank. Even this thing happened with me last year. So to overcome these things actually, you have to appear for mock test. Mock test is not just solving the questions, you know, you have, while you are appearing for mock test, you have to prepare a strategy, like, you know, how you will approach the questions, how you'll manage the time, that's most important. If you're facing a tough questions, whether to leave it or approach it, how to make your mind cool that time if you are facing a tough questions. So all these things actually you have to be ready when you are, you know, you have to prepare yourself when you are appearing for mock test. So these are the thing most crucial. It's not only about question solving. Now what I used to do is, there are few things I used to do when I used to appear for mock test. Firstly, you know, my strategy was like this, like for when I was appearing for a mock test, first I solve the aptitude part. Secondly, I used to solve the 2 marks questions, because 2 marks are much more tricky and they carry more marks actually. So with fresh mind, I try to focus on those questions. And finally, you know, at the end, I used to solve the 1 marks question because they are relatively easy. My second strategy was, I used to solve first, you know, one by one questions. If I find it tricky or time consuming, I used to leave it. And after, you know, completing one pass or one scan, I'll come back and solve all those questions. So this was roughly my strategy. Second point I used to tell you, that if questions are coming too hard or too tough, don't be panic, because you know, if you are unable to solve 5-6 questions, even 10 questions, then also you can score more than 70, and that's a pretty good score in GATE. So don't be panic. Next point is, as I told you, that each word are important for GATE questions. So you know, read each word, each sentence properly, and you know, and make sure that you gather all the information from a question, so that you will not do any silly mistake. So this is very crucial. Next is very crucial actually. Don't take success in GATE in mock test seriously. Suppose you are doing very well in mock test in everywhere, you are coming top 50 or top 10, don't take it seriously, because those 65 questions on the final day will be totally different. Obviously, if you are doing good in mock test, there is a high probability that you will good in GATE, but that is not always true. So don't be self-satisfied or self-complacent that I'll do good in the GATE examination. You just take it as a, you know, platform to practice, and you just do all these things, all this hall management purpose. So that's it. And but if you are doing many mistakes in the mock test, take it seriously. Obviously, if you are not doing good, take it seriously, study hard, and you know, make sure that you are not repeating those mistakes. For that, what I did was I used to maintain a diary for those mistakes, and I used to write all those mistakes in my diary. And I used to revise those things weekly, or you know, after 15 days, that what are the mistakes I am doing, so that it will not repeat in future. Like one mistake I just remember, like in DFA many have a tendency to do this mistake actually, to in minimization problem we forgot to count the dead state. That was a common mistake. I used to write it in my diary, and in final exam I said, you know, when the question came I still remember it and I made it correct. So make a copy of all the mistakes. Now there are many test series available in market, both paid and free. Like many institution is providing us the mock test, you can take any of it. And free mock test there are virtual gate is there. But again I'm telling you that don't take it seriously. Just take it as a platform that you will just solve the questions and prepare your strategy for the final day, because those 3 hours 65 questions will be always new to you. So this is just for, you know, preparing your strategy, how you will handle the time, how handle the pressure. That's it. And now next is revision. Once you are studying the topic, after some time you have to revise the topic also, otherwise you will, you know, you will forget those topic. So periodic revision is very important. There is a very common way to do this. Like when you are studying a topic, you know, you make some notes from that topic, some short notes, some important point you note down in your copy, and at the time of revision you just, you know, review all those points. So it will actually help you to remind all those topics that you've studied. I will suggest you to make your own handbook. You know, you read topic from different sources and, you know, try to collect different points and write it in your handbook. That will actually is more helpful, because it will, you know, as you are writing in your notebook, so it will help you to remind those points for a longer period of time. So you refer those books, but you make your own handbook, and these things actually will help you when in the time of your final revision before GATE. So revision and handbook is very important. Routine study, this is very crucial for those who actually are planning to drop one year for 2000, you know, next year GATE. The thing is, you have to make sure that you are utilizing your 24 hours in a proper way and not wasting much of your time. So for that you need a proper plan, proper routine to be followed. And what I used to do is, like, I used to maintain a diary, and before going to sleep for the day I used to write down my plan for the next day. So when I wake up the next day, I already knew that what are the things that I have to do, what are the subjects, what the theory I have to study, what are the tests I have to give. So I already have a plan with me. So I think it's very crucial for those who are preparing, who are dropping and preparing for the next time. Plan properly and you know, make sure that you are not wasting much of your time. Few people asked me actually that how did I manage time and how did I prepare my routine. So I just want to share a rough idea about my routine. What I used to do is I allocate morning time for theory study and revise. Then from afternoon to evening I used to give mock tests, and then after dinner I used to analyze those mock tests. So this was roughly my routine for every day. But obviously you make as per your convenience, as per your choice the routine, but make sure that you are not wasting much of your time, because time is very limited for you all of you guys. So be careful about it. And now the last part is the final 1 month. That is very important, what you will do in the final 1 month, because this is the time, you know, your focus will be much more on studies and all. So it is my personal suggestion, you know, you don't give much more mock tests in that period of time. You know, whatever mock tests you have to give, you give before December, or, you know, before January actually. Do all those mock tests before that, and from January till GATE, you know, what I did was I started revising all those theories. I started, you know, revising all the previous paper again, and I started revising all the, you know, difficult question I encountered in this period, in this last 6-7 months. So this period, you know, you have to actually, you know, revise everything, and it's good that you don't, you know, give much mock test this time. Even I didn't give a single one. Only one test I have given in the last 1 month, and it was actually a plan I built last year only. That you know, last year my paper was 2016 my paper was set one, and for this 1 year I never look set two paper. And my plan was I'll appear this paper in January, so that you know I will get a original paper of that tender which has been developed, which has been formed by IIT before going to the main examination. So you know, I in January first I revised everything, prepare, you know, solved previous year paper once, and I think in third or fourth week, I don't remember actually, I have given the test, that test actually, the set two paper I have given, and I remember that I got 72. And it gives me the confidence that yes, now I can do it, because you know, those questions are the questions that is made by IISc last year, and those kind of questions you expect in GATE. So I will suggest everybody that you know, who will appear again in 2018 and who tried in 2017, not to look the paper which you didn't appear in 2017. Keep it for next year Jan, and give the exam before going to the main exam and evaluate. That will be the real evaluation of your, you know, of your preparation and all. And if you are doing really good, it's a huge confidence that you will gain that you can do it now. So that's how you have to prepare for the first final month. Revise and you know, practice previous year paper. That's it. Don't give much mock test that period of time. And this is all about my GATE preparation. Now coming to the ISRO preparation part. In ISRO you have to face two phases actually. First you have to appear in written test, then if you can clear the written test you have to face interview. ISRO written test preparation is similar like GATE preparation. Again you have to solve those questions, but I must say that you know, it's much easier, because you know, in ISRO in 2015 and 2016 it has been seen that many questions has been copied from GATE previous year questions. So it's much easier. So what you need to do is, you know, apart from practicing questions, you need to make sure that you are solving previous year GATE and ISRO paper thoroughly. Those are very crucial, because a decent amount of question may be repeated from there. So make sure that you are practicing those previous year questions very well. And if you can clear the written test, you have to face interview. It will be a panel for I think 8 or 9 people whom you have to face on the day of interview. My experience was like, they used to ask you questions from your final year project first. So they will ask you about final year project, and if it is, you know, if it is interesting to them, they will ask you a lot of questions. Like my final year project was based on image technography, which is related to information security. So 50% of my interview was on that topic, my final year project. They asked me many questions, and then they asked me about my favorite subject, and I told them data structure algorithm and TOC. So they asked me few questions from there, and finally they asked me randomly a few questions. Like they asked me one question from compiler, one question related to COA, one question was there from networking, and some questions were there from plus two level math, like those geometry questions. So this is all about the interview experience. So make sure that you have a good command on your final year project. If it is really interesting project, then obviously you should have a good command, and you should have a depth knowledge from your subjective area. So that is all about ISRO preparation. I forgot to mention, many people have this query that whether they should join coaching institute or not. Personally, I think that if you have, you know, if you are not sure about your concepts, if you don't think that your basic knowledge is clear, definitely you can join any of the coaching institute. That depends upon you. Personally, I joined last year GATE forum, and I used to attend classes in the weekends. And it helps me up to certain level. Obviously, those classes by different professors helps me to understand different topics. But one thing I want to say all of the future aspirants, that don't only rely upon the, you know, classroom coachings, because classroom coachings does not guarantee success. what you need to do is you take, you know, you take concept from those professor or experts in classroom, come back and, you know, read books also parallelly with those notes, because those notes are not, only those notes are not sufficient. You have to read textbooks also. So, you know, you read both the things and prepare your note. That's what I used to do in the weekdays. I used to study both parallelly, textbook and the note given by my professors, and I used to prepare my own note, and that actually helps me a lot. So that's my suggestion, that if you are not sure about your concepts, go to any of the coaching institute, but you make sure that you are also studying the standard books and lectures. Second thing I want to say, that you know, like every day be consistent with your study. It's not like that you have to study more than 15 or 14 hours. That is not actually necessary. You can study for 6 or 8 hours per day average, but be consistent and plan accordingly, you as per your you know, comfort zone and all, but make sure that you are studying in a consistent manner. That is very important for any examination, not only GATE, for ISRO also it is very important. This is all about my story, my experience that I've just shared you with you all of you guys. It was a pretty tough journey. For last 2 years I was trying for these two prime dream, and finally it happened. So my final suggestion to all of the future aspirants will be like this: you just keep working hard, be focused. You know, if you have a dream, protect it. Whatever others are saying, don't bother about it, because you only know the value of your dream. So push yourself, keep working hard. And one of my teacher told me online, I want to conclude this video with that if you work hard and if you believe in yourself, miracle does happen. Believe me, it happened with me. It may take some time, but it will definitely happen. I wish that it will happen to every GATE aspirant in future. So that's it. Keep believe in yourself, keep working hard, and good luck to all of you. For any query, you can send me mail. My mail ID is kishaloy.msit@gmail.com, or you can contact me in Facebook. I am even active in GATE Overflow also. You can contact me there also. So good luck and best wishes for the future. Bye.